bed.
Okay, let's tuck you in, Rhino. Well, hope you had a good day.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's get those glasses off of you. Well, do you need a story tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do a pack story tonight.
Okay,
we've got a pack of almond cat. All right, first card is Soul Stinger out of the ground, crawling out just like a spider out of a cave, and just burst through the ground as a Soul Stinger, and is a scorpion sort of demon, okay? It has these stinging arms. I don't know how it puts anything in its mouth, though. And it ends up meeting up with a hooded brawler. It's a Naga warrior. It's a snake. And as you know, snakes and scorpions don't really mix very well, do they?
Yeah.
They are almost mortal enemies. All right. But the hooded brawler can exert extra energy and ends up killing the Soul Stinger. Now, the hooded brawler invokes the name of Oketra, in Oketra's name, and there's zombies. Soul Stinger has been involved. Okay. Exerts the name of Oketra as, look, Oketra, I have destroyed the Soul Stinger. Now, Oketra sends a giant spider. I don't know why. She just sends one. Or maybe a giant spider just shows up at the same time and is going to wrap up the hooded Naga, hooded brawler, the Naga warrior. But at the moment, the ground releases a spray of magma and destroys the spider and the hooded brawler. Then, with all that magma around, as it cools, you can see the rock formations in there, just like the painted bluffs. All these different colors from all the different types of rock and things as it cool at different rates. An angel comes down, the winged shepherd, and graces the now clean land of Amenket. But from the distance, a stinging shot flies through the air and hits the winged shepherd as it falls and plummets to its doom at the painted bluffs. But it has a supernatural stamina. It just exerts its incredible ability and pulls the arrows out from its chest, and the wounds start to seal back up. And as its wounds start to heal up, these mummies come out of the ground. They were Oketra's mummies. They're sparring mummies to help protect the winged shepherd. And the winged shepherd, now with its super stamina, turns itself into a seraph of the suns. It now flies up, completely indestructible. As it flies up, it calls forth out of the ground all of the zombies, the mummies, and they all start returning as the embalmed. They start marching. The Shadowstorm Vizier in the distance sees them coming towards her. She knows that this is the power of Oketra. And that, what does she do? She flies and cycles his car. Okay, so as they start coming, she starts gaining the power from the zombies, and she heads towards the throne of the god Pharaoh. So we have a seraph of the suns and the Shadowstorm Vizier in front of a horde, large horde of embalmed zombies, mummies, and they're all headed towards the throne of the god Pharaoh. And the throne of the god Pharaoh is on a very special island. It's like, it has a moat around it. It's like in the middle of a lake. So they all head towards the throne of the god Pharaoh. And then they find there the Avian Initiate as a zombie. As a mummy. And that is the end of this part of the story. And it will continue in our next pack.
That was a great story, Dad.
Thank you. So, time for good mages to go to bed.
Yeah.
Good night, buddy.
Good night. Make sure you click like on each of my videos, it helps out a lot. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And there are a few things here and here that may interest you. I have more videos coming out soon, and until then, Rhino out.